For Gail Duchess, the real danger behind the wheel is what she can't see in her rearview mirror.
They all play on your mind sometimes when you're backing out, especially if you live in a neighborhood, you know, with kids, dogs.
Could the reverse alarm be the answer to Gail's fears?
Looking at it, it's a little small, but if it does its job, it would be a great thing.
You don't mind making a little bit of noise when you're backing up?
No. Not if it's going to save the car or maybe save a family pet.
The four-step instructions say just stick the reverse alarm to the car taillight and it's ready to go.
Now, if everything goes according to plan, it should let off a loud siren as it backs up, alerting me the fact it is backing up so I can move out of the way.
Got my mirrors adjusted. I'm ready to go.
There's the car. Gail's inside. I'm back here, and I'm not looking at the car. If this device works, I should hear a siren, and I'll be able to move out of the way. If not, well, at least my insurance is all paid up.
Here she comes, and there it goes.
I hear it. I hear this. There it is. You can hear the beep. It's faint, but you can hear it.
That's inside the carport here. But what about outside?
Okay, now we're outside, and I can still hear it real faintly next to the road over here. You can barely hear it, but it does seem to work, so there's enough of a siren that I can get out of the way.
But it may not be loud enough to get the attention of a child, a pet, or even another car.
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, while in the vehicle with the windows up, I could hardly hear the alarm.
And without a louder sound, I could hardly give the reverse alarm more than 2 stars out of 4. Andrew Stocky, Channel 4 Action News.